National Association of Securities Dealers, as part of its drive to promote capital market development, engaged stakeholders in its interactive CEO forum. It was an opportunity for the CEO of the NASD, Mr. Bola Ajomale, to present the state of the operations and its agenda for the market.
One of the first things he said is that active investors are looking for companies with growth potential in Africa, and they look past the macro indicators. So they're not only looking at, we as individuals in the economy, we're looking at, what's the naira to dollar rate, what's this, what's that, inflation is, Buhari hasn't, and so on. Active investors are not looking at that. They're looking at, where's the best place for me to put my money long term? We are competing for investment funds with the rest of the world. It's not just us looking for business. We should stop looking at us looking for business within Lagos. We are competing with the rest of the world. That money is not sentimental. It is not Africa money. It is not dedicated to this part of the world. It is money that can fly in any direction, depending on whether your conditions are right and whether you're offering the right return and whether your risk is something that they can tolerate. Driving down markets for gain, or driving down markets in a mass movement, as we've seen with our graph, is counterintuitive. It destroys the market and it pushes investments away from this market. It doesn't bring investments to this market or to Africa generally. Something we must actively do and aggressively do is encourage transparency and good corporate governance. Another thing is, the more educated all stakeholders are, and by education, I don't necessarily mean whether you have a master's, a PhD, or whatever, but the more aware you are of the use, of the availability of information, the utilization of that information, and the more you spread it around, and the more you can reach the right decisions based on that information, the more vibrant the market will be. Six, if we harness the power of that information and technology, we can create a much bigger picture than we already have. If you don't use the power of technology, then you will not know what's happening right next door to you. If you don't harness the power of information, you will not share that information that you have, and so nobody else can see what you see. But once those two come together, we can actually create a much bigger picture of the Nigerian economy, of the NASD OTC market, and with a bigger picture, we have more to offer to investors, we have a more vibrant market. In any emerging market, provided the operators have done their research, you cannot be a proprietary trader without having done your research. And you have a major part to play if you are a proprietary trader, because that way you're moving in and out, you're leveling curves, and at the same time, you are also ensuring that there's liquidity on the market.
Mr. Mecca Madubike, key stakeholder in the Nigerian capital market, and the NASD CEO, Mr. Bola Ajomale, speak further on the essence of the forum.
You know, interactions are always good. They are platforms for you to share ideas. You know, new ideas come, people are incentivized, people are charged to come up with new things that will happen. Because at the end of the day, this market needs to grow. And so we must continue. And the good thing is that we're going to have these interactions on a continuing basis. And I believe that the market will continue to get better.
Right now, we believe that the market is covering a microcosm of what potentially it will cover when it gets fully developed and when it's cruising at full speed. So how do we get there, and how can it be of advantage to all the players, all the stakeholders, including the regulators themselves?
We need to continue to tweak with the structure, the issues of transparency, the issues of information sharing. For me, those are the critical things that I think we need to work on. And the issues of collaboration and interaction with other platforms and other associations and other stakeholders within the entire marketplace.
What we see looking forward is that we anticipate, or we know, and part of what was shared in this meeting today is that we believe some of the securities we have right now are at even below the intrinsic value. And so we can see that there's some extremely exciting opportunities coming up for investors on the market that they can lock into some pretty good investments right now. We see the constraint being that of the environment, being the economy, the macroeconomy,
We see a great opportunity once we can, and that's part of what we shared as well. We see a great opportunity once we can harness the power of technology, the power of information. We can see that we have a great market coming ahead. In terms of the global economy itself, we think there will probably be a turnaround by the third quarter. Second quarter, I think we will begin, if we can start slowing down on the slide that we had before, and I think it's coming to a standstill now, and then we can start reversing. If we can slow that down enough and we can start rebuilding, then I think there will be some kind of resurgence. I think we need to get our heads around the fact that we're not going to go back to anything above $50 per barrel. And I think the economy will therefore shift. And that's part of what we're talking about in NASD as well, that we think the economy is going to shift away from big companies to the smaller ones, to the growth companies. And that's where a lot of power is going to be, a lot of energy will be. We see a lot of activity happening in the private equity industry. We see a lot of investors, big investors, looking at Africa, looking at Nigeria as investment targets. It's a timing issue. So second quarter, third quarter, we think those times will get closer.
With the unfolding strategies of the NSD, it is expected that this will translate to market enhancement and expansion for Nigeria.